Piercing the pre-dawn skies, the space shuttle announces its arrival at the launch site with its signature sound of twin sonic booms having gone subsonic for the last time. Having fired the imagination of a generation, a ship like no other, its place in history secured, the space shuttle pulls into port for the last time.
Humanity has left Earth many times before. From our Florida shoreline. Some of the most inspiring missions of adventure began here at Kennedy Space Center and would not have been successful without our hard work. That work and expertise will always be a hallmark of our efforts here, though we are retooling for the future. Kennedy helped America take important steps before and now.
We are getting ready to make our next giant leap. We are remaking NASA's Kennedy Space Center into the world's premier multi-user spaceport, ultimately launching missions beyond low Earth orbit and taking people to destinations far beyond anywhere humans have gone before.
Making unneeded facilities available to commercial space is one of the best ways to enable this new industry. We're also making the Kennedy Space Center more accessible to the entrepreneurs who are already driving the next space age.
It began with opening up facilities at Kennedy to requests that would use them in new and different ways. A team from Johnson Space Center is using a lunar simulation field to make free flights of an autonomous lander at the shuttle runway. Aerospace companies are exploring the iconic facility as a starting point and finish line of suborbital missions, carrying experiments and paying passengers into weightlessness.
No one has ever tried to repurpose a major installation like the Kennedy Space Center, but we are getting it done.
Up at Launch Complex 39 and the Vehicle Assembly Building area, crews got to work replacing infrastructure that was installed at the beginning of the space age. The computers, wiring, and cabling were cutting edge 50 years ago and got America to the moon. Now, though, the equipment was worn and obsolete. The changes reached deep into the heart of the landmark Vehicle Assembly Building. Rusted pipes, corroded cables, antiquated data and electrical wiring were removed, fashioning the crown jewel of the Kennedy Space Center into a facility capable of assembling the next generation of American rockets for both private companies and NASA missions.
NASA began work on the Space Launch System design, a gigantic rocket capable of taking our astronauts far beyond low Earth orbit. With this 32-story super rocket being built in the spirit of Saturn V, we knew we would be looking again at reaching far out into space. Asteroids and Mars are suddenly within reach, but we knew it would take a special launch complex to handle it. We didn't have to look far for the foundation, Launch Complex 39B, right here.
Cranes and workers descended on Launch Complex 39B and began their critical work. They took down the fixed service structure and rotating service structure built for the space shuttle. The salt air on the coast of the Atlantic Ocean took its toll on the proud structures, but workers soon took to restoring their glory. They sandblasted fuel and support lines that ran from storage tanks to the pad and to the spacecraft. As in the VAB, conduits and cables were torn out and replaced with modern electronics and capabilities undreamt of previously.
While they're getting ready for our new rocket, engineers and technicians at the other end of the Space Center, in a place we call the Operations and Checkout Building, are getting ready for a new spaceship. This is the High Bay. It's the pristine work area where engineers and technicians just finished assembling the Orion for its first test flight. It's kind of like a garage for spaceships. And remember that part about making the VAB able to handle more than one rocket and spacecraft? Well, that's what we're doing here too. Lockheed Martin, who assembled the Orion, can use this assembly area for other spacecraft when they're not working on Orion.
It's good to think about the future and make plans, but all of us out here knew we had to keep doing what we are here for, launching rockets. Although the shuttle retired, NASA never stopped exploring. In fact, In many ways, we picked up the pace. We launched the huge Juno spacecraft to Jupiter, the first probe dispatched to the gas giant since NASA's Galileo in 1989. Kennedy's teams continued going to Vandenberg Air Force Base to launch Earth Observing Mission, and no one will ever forget the Curiosity rover we launched to Mars. Right now, that car-sized laboratory is traversing the rust-colored soil of the Red Planet, unlocking geologic mysteries we didn't even know to ask about.
The International Space Station has been counting on us too. Just as we did during shuttle, we continue to deliver. Cargo resupply missions launching from Florida gave Kennedy its first look at its spaceport destiny. Rockets and spacecraft built by private companies went from experimental to operational. Their launches became common sights. Aboard the space station, crew members were able to unpack the cargo craft to find supplies and the all-important scientific experiments they would operate. The space station needs are also driving a new approach to doing business with America's aerospace firms.
In the commercial crew program, after working with our partners for the last 4 years, we are looking forward to seeing their hardware, but we are going to love to watch them launch our crews to the International Space Station.
We've made the initial transition to become a multi-user spaceport, but we still have a ways to go to fully implement our vision. We're solidifying our position as America's preeminent spaceport, supporting both government and commercial launches to and from low Earth orbit and beyond. A spaceport worthy of all those who've gone before and of those who will one day take us on a journey to Mars.